giving heartfelt thanks at Tacloban's Redemptionist Church to surviving a second major storm to hit this city in a little more than a year. Sunday Mass, a serene break from this church's new role as an evacuation centre. 1,500 people, almost the entire parish, cramming together with their belongings and pets to ride out Hagupit.
How scared were you that there could be another Yolanda?
Really scared, because I imagine what happened last year, but I have to trust God.
Some left at first light, but many are staying longer until the typhoon is clear of the region or until their damaged homes are repaired. For virtually all in this city, it stirred raw and painful memories of a little more than a year ago. 18-year-old Art Martinez lost both parents when they stayed too late to escape Typhoon Haiyan's devastating storm surge. As he shows me the remains of his family home, he says he evacuated early this time, but said he was still terrified.
I'm the only one who is still awake, so I'm still praying that God, please help us, please help us, please help us. I know that you will help us.
And do you think he did?
Yes.
The reminders of what happened here a little more than a year ago are hard to miss. And they're also potent symbols of the bitter lessons learned. The most important of those, to get out of harm's way and to get out early. Nearly 50,000 people fled to evacuation centres, churches and schools. Even private families took strangers in. Most voluntarily, some forced. Authorities here were not going to have a repeat of last year. But in the end, Hagupit did little more than brush Tacloban. Damage limited to localised flooding, downed trees and roofs ripped from shanties. Parish priest Father Eliodoro Retorasion at the Redemptionist Church says people have resigned themselves to the fact that storms will always be a part of their lives.
I encountered so many questions like that. Is it the will of God or the wrath of God? But now, they feel that it is just part of nature.
A part of nature they pray won't revisit this city anytime soon. Andrew Stevens, CNN Tacloban, the Philippines.